Friends, in this video, we are solving one problem based on the basic equation of induction motor. So let's begin. Friends, in this video, we are solving one of the problem based on the induction motor. I think we have already studied about different equations of induction motor. So friends, we can solve one of the problem based on your induction motor. Friends, as we know that it is the induction motors are very popular in the industry, because near about 80% industrial motors are the induction motors. So induction motors problem is totally based on its basic principle, that is called as a mutual induction. So we can understand what was the problem statement. So friends, the problem statement is that 440 volt, 50 hertz, 6 pole, 950 rpm star connected induction motor has following parameters referred to the stator. So friends, in the first line we are getting the rating of your induction motor. So as we know that the induction motor has different types. Such motors are called as the squirrel cage induction motor and slip ring induction motor. So friends, in that particular problem we are having the squirrel cage induction motor, and the connection of this motor will be a star connected. So this should be the symbol of your star connected. Okay, this will be the symbol of your star connected induction motor. So friends, the motor which will having the voltage, that is 440 volt, frequency 50 hertz, number of poles are 6 number of poles, and the speed of that particular motor will be the 950 rpm. So friends, we can understand the different equivalent parameters of your induction motor. So friends, in the given problem, we are having the first parameter, which is called as the stator resistance, and the value of your stator resistance is what? 0.5 ohm. That will be the first thing. Then the second thing that we are having, value of the rotor resistance will be the referred stator, so that's why it is called as R dash R, so is equal to 0.4 ohm. Value of the excess is the synchronous reactance, and that will be the synchronous reactance in concern with your rotor circuit. So the synchronous reactance in concern with your stator circuit and rotor circuit referred to the stator, both have the same value, that is 1.2 ohm. The XM is the mutual reactance of your induction motor equivalent circuit, that will be the 50 ohm. So friends, these are the different parameters of your induction motor. So friends, this motor is driving a fan load. So friends, as we know that this will be the problem of your electrical drive. So in electrical drive, as we know that according to the fundamental of your block diagram, the induction motor will be used for a fan load, means by the use of the induction motor we are driving one of the fan load. So the motor torque of that particular load, or the load torque of that particular motor, which will be given by, means the load torque of your particular motor, because basically we are connecting, as we draw the basic block diagram of your electrical drive. So friend, this will be the first block of your electrical drive. We called it as source. Second block, which is called as power modulator. Third block, which is called as motor. Okay. Next block is called as load. So from motor load, we are connecting one sensor. From sensor, we are connecting one control unit. From control unit, we are giving the supply to your power modulator, and we are giving the input to your control unit. So friends, this is induction motor as a load, and this induction motor will be applying the load as a fan load. So friends, as we know that the induction motor which will having a motor torque, load has its different torque. This is called as TL. So in the given problem, we are having the value of this load torque. So this will be the load torque of your problem. This will be the load torque of your problem. Okay. So this is 0.0123 omega m square. So this will be the value of your load torque. So that will be the value of the load torque. Now, friends, now you can see what will be the condition. Now, one phase of motor is fails, means that we are supplying a three-phase supply, because it is a three-phase induction motor. So out of that particular three-phase supply, suppose one phase is fails, then At that time, we want to find out the value of the motor speed, because value of the rotor speed that we are having, that is 950 RPM. But when the motor will one phase is fails, that is called as the single phasing operation, that time we want to calculate the value of current and speed. And next thing is that in the given problem that we had asked, what will be, or will it be safe to allow the motor to run for a long period? So at that, the value of your speed and current, we want to find out whether the motor will be run for a long period, yes or no. So this is the problem which is basically asked to you. Okay, so friends, this will be the problem. So again, I can repeat once the problem, so you can get the basic concept. So in the given problem that we are having, 440 volt, 50 hertz, 6 pole, 950 star connected induction motor has the following parameters referred to the stator. So the stator resistance is 0.5 ohm, rotor resistance referred to stator is 0.4 ohm, value of the synchronous reactance and the stator reactance and rotor reactance is 1.2 ohm, the value of the mutual reactance is 50 ohm. So the motor is driving a fan load. The load torque of this fan or this motor, it is TL is equal to 0.0123 omega m square. And now one phase of motor is fails, means single phasing occurs, and at that time we want to find out the value of the motor speed and current, and will it be safe to follow the motor for a long period. So this will be the actual problem basically asked in concern with your induction motor. So friends, we can write what are the different given things which are available to your problem. So this will be the voltage of your motor, that is 440 volt. Frequency of your supply, that is 50 hertz. The number of poles are 6 number of poles. The speed of your motor, that is 950 RPM. So these are basically in concern with your induction motor ratings. And these are the various parameters. That is, RS is called as the, I can write you, so you can get the concept. RS is called as the stator resistance. That is, R dash R is called as a rotor resistance. Rotor resistance referred to stator circuit. Referred to stator circuit. This is XS and X dash R. These are the synchronous stator and rotor reactance. XM is the mutual reactance that we are having. The value of the mutual reactance is 50 ohm in the given problem. The load torque, basically friends, as given in the problem, that the motor torque, means this will be the induction motor driving a load, and such load is called as fan load. So we are having the different torque, which is called as motor torque, and this will be the load torque. Okay, and this will be the load torque of your fan, and we are having the value of this load. Okay, this load torque, what will be the value? This is called as 0.0123 omega m square. So it is load torque. The load will be considered as fan. Okay, and in that particular operation, now motor will be on a single phasing fault, means a single phasing fault will occur in that particular motor, and this will be the given thing in your problem. From that particular thing, now we want to find out the different thing. So what we want to find out from that particular different thing, first thing we want to find out, one phase of a motor will fail, means motor will be operating in a single phasing fault. We call it as, in another word, single phasing. Why it is called as single phasing? Because as we know that we are giving the three phase supply to your motor, that is R, Y and B. Suppose one of the phase of your motor will be fails, means fault will occur. That time the motor will be run on these particular phases. So this fault is called as a single phasing. Okay, then the motor will be basically operating at a single phasing. And at that time of single phasing, what should be the value of the motor speed, that is asked for us. then what should be the value of the motor current that is asking for us. And next thing that we want to find out, will it be safe to allow the motor current to run for a longer period? Means it will be safe for that particular induction motor to allow that particular single phasing fault for a long period. Otherwise, it will be dangerous. So that condition we want to find out in that particular problem. So basically, we can find out this value by means of the comparing of the value of your current. If the current value of your normal is greater than the single phasing current, that time the system will be safe. But if the value of the that particular single phasing current is more than your normal rating current, that time the system will not be safe. So from that particular problem, we can get what will be the value of the motor current at the single phasing and what will be the value of the motor current at the normal condition. Okay, so friends, let's we can start to solve the problem. For the solving of your problem, first of all, this will be your induction motor, and for your induction motor operation, first thing that we want to find out value of the synchronous speed. Okay, so what will be the formula of the synchronous speed of your induction motor? I can write synchronous speed is what? It is the speed at which your rotating magnetic field will rotate, and we are having the very basic fundamental formula of the synchronous speed, that is 1/20 upon p. So friends, in given problem, we are having the value of the frequency. It is 120 into 50 divided by number of poles, 6. Okay, so it will be give you the value of your synchronous speed, that is 1000 rpm. So this will be called as the synchronous speed ns. We denote this speed as ns. This is called as synchronous speed, 1000 rpm. So friends, we are having a very fundamental formula that will be the value of the speed in terms of rpm, but for the solving of your problem, sometimes we will require the speed in concern with the angular velocity. So we have the fundamental formula of conversion of speed, that is omega m is equal to pi n by 60. So now we can convert that the value of the speed into angular velocity. So we are substituting the value of the speed, that is 2 pi into 1000 divided by 60. So we are getting the value of the angular velocity in terms of radian per second, and that will be the 104.72 radian per second. So friends, what we are getting? We are getting the value of speed in terms of RPM, and we are getting the value of the speed in terms of angular velocity. Because sometime we will require speed in RPM, sometime we will require speed in angular velocity. So after that, now we can find out the value of your slip. So we are having the formula of your slip. Slip is what? Synchronous speed minus actual speed or rotor speed divided by ns. So in the given problem, we are having the value of n, that is 950, and we have calculated the value of the ns, that is 1000 rpm. So now we can substitute, that is 1000 minus 950 divided by 1000. So we are getting the value of your slip, and what should be the value of the slip? Now the value of slip is your 0.05. So this will be the value of your slip. This will be a very, very important thing, because before we going to start the any of the problem, we want to find out the very, very important parameter of your induction motor. That is, first will be the synchronous speed, okay, and second one will be the slip. That will be the slip of your induction motor. So what should be the value of the synchronous speed in terms of RPM? That is 1000. Synchronous speed in terms of radian per second, that is 104.72 radian per second, and the value of the slip is what? 0.05. So this will be the basic things in concern with your induction motor. Friends, now we can move towards finding out the value of the current. So friends, we are having a very fundamental formula in concern with current, that is the I dash R, that is the rotor current of your induction motor, refer to the stator. We can have the fundamental formula, V divided by RS plus R dash R upon S plus J into XS plus X dash R. So this will be the formula of your I dash R. So friends, in the given problem that we want to find out the value of the I dash r, but in that particular problem the value of j is what? Imaginary part. So now we can convert that the same formula of your current, that will be the fundamental equation, that is x plus jy. Now if you want to remove this complex number, then we can take simply it is x square plus y square, that is square root of x square plus y square. Similarly thing that we can be applying here, so we can getting the value of the rotor current referred to your stator, it is v divided by square root of, that is rs. Now we can directly substitute the value of the rs from the given equation. So what should be the value of the rs in the given problem? So the value of the rs in the given problem is what? 0.5. value of r dash r is with us, the value of the r dash r is 0.4. the value of the slip that we had already calculated, 0.05 bracket square, because we want to get this term, plus we are having the value of xs and xr, it is 1.2 plus 1.2 bracket square. So while we are substituting this value in your calculator, we are getting the value of the I dash r, that is the rotor current referred to the stator. And what should be the value of the rotor current? Because in the given problem we are having the value of the voltage, and what should be the value of the voltage? That will be the 440 volt, but friends, this will be the three phase voltage. But for the equivalent circuit, we want to convert this three phase voltage by a single phase voltage. Okay, so that's why we can divide it by root 3. So now we can substitute the value of V, that is 440 divided by root 3, into that equation. So in calculator, we are getting the value of this volt term, that is 440 divided by root 3 divided by square root of 0.5 plus 0.4 divided by 0.05 bracket square plus 1.2 plus 1.2 bracket square. So we are getting the value of the rotor current referred to the stator. And what should be the value of the rotor current referred to the stator? So the value of the rotor current referred to the stator is, now it is 28.76 at an angle of minus 15.77 degrees. So this value is current ampere. Okay, because this will be the angle, because we are getting the value into the polar quantities. So what should be the value of the rotor current? That is 28.76 ampere with an angle of minus 15.77. so this will be the rated current of your induction motor that we had already found out. Okay, so friends, as we know that in concern with your induction motor circuit, we are having a basic equivalent circuit. So that the equivalent circuit is look like that. This will be the value of the stator current, and this is equal to your value of your rotor current at value of your IM. Okay, so what do you mean by that particular IM? It is a mutual current. So we want to get the value of the stator current, because this will be the value of your rotor current, but now we want to the value of your total induction motor circuit. So it will be the stator current value. So what should be the value of the stator current, friends? So stator current value is what? It will be the I dash r basically, because it these all values are referred to your stator. So we called it as I dash r plus IM. In the given problem, we had already find out the value of the I dash r. So this will be the value of the 28.76 at an angle of minus 15.77 degree ampere, and we want to find out the value of the IM. So we can get the value of the IM by means of a simple fundamental formula, because of a frequency of your supply, it will be your 50 hertz. So if you want to get the value of the IM, we want to get very basic fundamental equation, that is IM is equal to 440 by root 3, because this will be the voltage, into frequency, that is 50 hertz. Okay, so we are getting the angle between this current and this current is basically 90 degrees. So it will be at an angle of 90 degree, that is minus 90 degree. So we can substitute the value of this IM into that equation, that is 440 by root 3 into 50 at an angle of minus 90 degree into that particular equation. So we are getting the value of the IS. So what should be the value of the IS? So now we can calculate these all terms with the help of your scientific calculator. So we are getting the value of the stator current. So the value of the current is 30.5 at an angle of minus 25 degree. Okay, so this will be the required solution of your total induction motor's current. Okay, so that will be the equivalent value of your current, because this will be the rotor current, but in the equivalent circuit of your induction motor we want to find out the value of the total current of your equivalent circuit. So the total current will be given by the stator current value, because the stator current will be divided into rotor current and the mutual value of current. We are now getting the value of your stator current, and this will be the rated value of your current. Okay, that will be the stator current. Okay, so friends, this will be the in concern with your finding out of your current. So we are getting the value of the total current of your equivalent circuit, that will be the induction motor. Now we considered when a single phasing fault will be occur on your system, then what will happen. So friends, now we can see when the single phasing fault will be the occur, then the equivalent circuit of your induction motor will be look like that, because when the single phasing fault will be occur, component that will be called it as the mutual component will be divided into two basic parts. First part is called as the positive sequence current, and second, which is will be the negative sequence current. So this will be the represented by the IP current, and this will be the IN. Okay, so this IP and IN are basically due to the single phasing fault operation, because in the given problem single phasing fault is occur on the system, that will be the given. So for that particular case, we are getting the equivalent circuit. So in the equivalent circuit, friends, we are having, so friends, for a single phasing operation of the induction motor, there are different parameters. So the first parameter, that is V, is called as the voltage which will be available across your motor. RS is again the stator value of your resistance. XS is called as the stator reactance. Okay, the IP is called as a positive sequence current, that will be called as positive sequence current. Then XM is a mutual reactance, X dash R is called as the rotor reactance referred to stator. Then this is called as the value of your R dash R upon S, where S is called as slip. Okay, so these are the terms. And the next term, that is again RS is a stator resistance, XS is the stator reactance, IN is called as the negative sequence current, because due to the single phasing such current are occurs, this is called as negative sequence current. The XM is the mutual value of reactance, the XR is the rotor reactance referred to the stator. But friends, due to the single phasing, the value of your slip will be the changes, because value of your basically slip will be the negative, because we are having the fundamental formula, that is omega m is equal to omega ms into 1 minus s. Now we can get the value of your slip at that particular place. So as we know that the formula omega ms minus omega m divided by omega ms. So if we are substituting the value of the omega m into that particular equation, so we are getting the value of the slip, that is 2 minus s. So we are getting the value of the slip, that is 2 minus s for that particular case. So friends, while a single phasing will occur, we are getting the value of the slip for the positive sequence, the value of your load slip, basically R dash R upon s, and the second, that is R dash R upon 2 minus s. Why it is 2 minus s? Because due to the value of your rotor speed or rotor angular velocity. Okay, so these are the basic terms referred to the single phasing circuit. Now friends, we can apply the same case into your problem. So in the given problem, we are getting the equivalent circuit becomes Because for the given problem, we want to find out the value of the equivalent circuit. That will be the similar to the previous circuit means. This will be the basic circuit, single phasing. Now we want to substitute all values as per your problem. So in the given problem, we are having the different terms. So in the given problem, that will be the voltage we are having 440 volt, but this will be the voltage that is three phase voltage. If you want to get the per phase voltage, so that's why we can divide it by root 3. We can get the value of V. Okay, so this will be the first term. Then the value of the RS, which will be given in your problem, that is 0.5 ohm. The value of the XS, that is synchronous reactance, that will be the 1.2 ohm. The value of the rotor reactance that we are having, that is 1.2 ohm. The value of XM that we are having in the problem, which is 50 ohm. And we are having the value of the R dash R, that will be the value 0.4. And now we can get the value, that is S, that is S is called as the slip at that particular positive sequence current. So friends, this is the positive sequence currents we can consider. This is the impedance of your circuit. This impedance will be called as ZF. ZF is the first part that is related to your positive sequence impedance. We call it as positive sequence impedance. And ZB, which is called as the negative sequence impedance. Friends, if you want to get the value of the IP and IN, so if you want to get the value of the current, that is IP and IN, we want to find out value of the ZF, positive sequence impedance and negative sequence impedance. So from the value of the particular impedance, we are getting the value of the current. So that will be the important thing. So in the given problem, from bottom hand side, XM value is again 50 ohm. Value of the X dash R, it is 1.2 ohm. The value of R dash R, R dash R is 0.4 ohm. Value of your slip, it is 2 minus S. Okay. So this will be the value of the RS, that is 0.5, that will be available with us in the given problem, XS 1.2 ohm. So these are, I can write what do you mean by the ZF. ZF is the basically positive sequence impedance. Positive sequence impedance. Why we are writing this positive sequence impedance, I can tell you, because according to the Ohm's law, if you want to get the current, that is I is equal to V by R, but in that particular circuit, it will be the AC circuit. So instead of R, we are getting the value of Z. It is impedance ZF for IP, and for IN, we are getting the value of ZB. It is called as negative sequence impedance. Negative sequence impedance of your circuit. So this will be the very, very important thing. Now friends, if you want to get the value of the positive sequence current, then definitely we should have the basic fundamental equations of your ZF. ZF is called as the value of the impedance. So as we know that ZF, according to the ZF, if you want to get the value of the ZF, so according to the fundamental basic concept of the ZF, it is nothing but it is called as the impedance, and which will be basically resistance plus reactance, R plus Jx. So we want to substitute all the values of your R and Jx into that particular term. So if you want to get the value of the ZF in concern with that circuit, we want to consider all these terms. You want to consider all these terms for your ZF. Similarly, if you want to get the value of the ZB, we want to consider all these terms. So if you get the value of ZF from here, you are getting value of the ZB from here, then it will be easy to calculate IP and IN. This will be the positive sequence current, this will be the negative sequence current. Okay, so we can start to solve or to calculate the value of the ZF for your problem. So we can getting the value of ZF, that should be the value of, now we can write it as the value of the ZF for your problem. So now we can write it as the formula, that is ZF is called as the positive sequence impedance, which is called as R plus JXS plus JXM. How we can calculate this? Simple, by means of this diagram, that is R dash R upon S plus J into X dash R. divided by R dash R upon S plus J into X dash R plus XM. So friends, we are having the all values of this term. Now we can substitute this the value. So the value of the R in that particular term, that is 0.5. The value of the XS, that is J into 1.2. The value of the XS 1.2. The value of J, we can write it as it is. The value of the XM is 50. The value of the R dash R, so R dash R value is 0.4. The value of slip that we had already calculated previously, that is 0.05, plus J into the value of the X R dash. So we are having the value of the X dash R, it is 1.2. Similarly, we can substitute the value of that particular term. It will be the R dash R upon S. What should be the value of the R dash R? It is 0.4 divided by S value 0.05 plus value of the XR dash plus XM. So the value of the XR dash is 1.2 and the XM is 50 ohm. So friends, now we can solve this term by means of your scientific calculator. Okay, so we are getting these all in terms of the rectangular value, means we are only calculating with the help of your calculator, that is 0.5 plus J 2.2 plus J into 15 bracket 0.4 divided by 0.05 plus J 1.2 bracket complete divided by 0.4 divided by 0.05 plus J into 1.2 plus 50. So simply we have to substitute this value into scientific calculator. So we are getting the value of the impedance, that is forward or positive sequence impedance of your circuit. So the value of the impedance, that is 7.94 plus J into 3.536 ohm. Okay, so friends, this will be the value of your positive sequence impedance. And basically, we are getting this term by means of the simple substituting the value in the scientific calculator of these all terms. We are getting directly this term. So this is called as a ZF. ZF is called as the basically positive sequence impedance. Similarly, friends, we can calculate the value for your ZB. So what should be the value of the ZB? So ZB is called as the negative sequence impedance. So again, we want to find out the value with respect to this term. So now we can write it as R plus JXS plus J into XM in bracket R dash R upon, friends, keep in mind when it will be a negative sequence current impedance. So basically the value of the slip is changed, and what should be the value of the slip is changed, that is 2 minus S, because we know that when the negative sequence current will occur, obviously the value of the slip will be the changes, then J into X dash R. Similarly, we want to substitute the value into the denominator value, that is R dash R upon, again the value of the slip is changed for that particular negative sequence impedance, that is 2 minus S, okay, plus J into X dash R plus XM. So again now we want to substitute the value of these all terms into that equation, so we can get the value of the ZB. So now we can find out the value of the ZB. What should be the value of the ZB? Simply we want to substitute all the values into that equation. So value of the ZB, now I can write here. So the value of the ZB, so the value of the RS is what? 0.5 plus J into value of the XS, it is 1.2 plus the value of again your XM, it is J into 50 in bracket. We are having the value of the R dash R. So we are having the value, that is 0.4 divided by 2 minus S. Okay. So that will be the basically 2 minus S means 2 minus S, that is 0.05. That is 2 minus 0.05. Okay. So this will be the plus J into the value of the XR. It is 1.2. Again, for the denominator side, again we want to substitute the value of the R dash R, that is 0.4 divided by 2 minus S, that is 2 minus 0.05 plus J into xm plus xr. So we are getting the value of the, that is 1.2 plus 50. So friends, now we can getting the value of zb, that is 0.5 plus j into 1.2 plus j into 50 in bracket 0.4 divided by 1.95 plus j into 1.2 divided by 0.4 divided by 1.95 plus j into 51.2. We're adding this term only. So when we are substituting these all value into your scientific calculator, we can getting the ZB value directly, that is called as a negative sequence impedance. What should be the value of the ZB? We are getting the value, that is 0.7 plus J into 2.7 ohm. We are getting directly value of your ZB. So friends, we are getting directly value of the ZB. So friends, as shown in figure, we have the basic concept. If you want to get the value of the ZB, so as shown in figure, friends, so if you want to calculate the total impedance of your circuit, so this is the total impedance of circuit, it is Z is equal to ZF plus ZB, because this will be the positive sequence impedance, this will be the negative sequence impedance. So we want to get the value of ZF plus ZB. So friends, now we can getting the value of the ZF plus ZB into that particular equation. So now we can get the equations. That will be the ZF plus ZB. So now we are getting the value. It will be the ZB equation. So now you want to calculate the value of your total Z. So the value of Z, now it will be total Z is equal to ZF plus ZB. Now we want to substitute the value of the ZF and ZB into that equation. So we are getting the value of the ZF. So I can write here. So Z is equal to ZF plus ZB. So the value of the ZF that will be given in the problem, that is 7.94 plus J into 3.536. And we are having the value of the ZB, it will be the 0.7 plus J into 2.37. So we are getting the value of the Z, that is total impedance of your circuit, we are getting value, that is 8.64 plus J into 5.91. So this will be the total impedance of your circuit. But friends, if you want to get the value of that particular impedance, why we want to calculate the value of this impedance? Because we want to calculate the value of the current for this case. So according to the Ohm's law, as we know that, according to Ohm's law, if you want to get the value of impedance, that is Z is equal to, obviously we are getting, basically if you want to get the value of the Z, so Z is equal to, obviously it is V by I. So if you want to get the value of I, then I is equal to what? V by Z. So now we want to substitute the value of V into that equation. So we want to calculate the value of the per phase current for the single phasing, because we are considering the single phase circuit. So now we can substitute the value of voltage. It is 440 by root 3 divided by the impedance of your circuit. So what should be the value of your impedance of your circuit? This will be the value, that is 8.64 plus J 5.9. If you want to get, convert this term, you want to convert this term into a polar quantity. So we can substitute this value as a rectangular quantity into that equation. But for calculation, now we want to convert this value into polar quantity. So from that particular thing, we are getting the value of the current. If you are substituting this value into your scientific calculator, means by converting this value into polar quantity, we are getting the value of the current. And what should be the value of the current? That the value of the current should be 24.25 ampere. So we are getting the value of the current at your single phasing. So we are getting the value of the total current at single phasing, that is, at the single phasing, we call it as a single phase fault. When the single phase fault occur, what should be the value of the current? Because previously the value of the current is 30 ampere. But now the value of the current is 24.25 ampere. So this will be the required first thing in your problem, that what should be the value of the motor current of your system. Okay, so this will be the first term. Now we want to move towards the second term, and that the second term that we want to calculate the value of your speed. So if you want to get the calculation of your speed, first of all we should know what should be the value of your positive sequence torque. So we are having the fundamental equation of your positive sequence torque. It is called as torque equation. Tp is equal to, we are having the basic equation of your torque, that is 1 divided by omega ms, in bracket we can write it as T into, it is I square xm square r dash r upon s divided by, we are having that fundamental equation of your positive sequence torque, that is r dash r upon s, that we had already derived in the previous video, that is x dash r plus xm. So this is called as basically the positive sequence torque. So now we can substitute these all value into that particular equation. So basically we are getting the term of Tp, that is positive sequence torque, and what should be the value of the that positive sequence torque. So value of the, basically I can write this term, so basically the value of the omega ms, so in terms of radian per second, so what should be the value of the speed, that is synchronous speed in terms of radians per second, that we had already calculated. So it is 104.72, we had already earlier calculated. So now we can substitute this all value into that equation. So what should be the value of that particular term? It is 3 into the value of the current at the single phasing, that is 24.25 bracket square into 50 bracket square into 0.4 divided by 0.05 divided by, now we can substitute the value of omega ms, that is 104.72 in bracket r dash r, value is 0.4 divided by value of sleep, that is 0.05 bracket square plus xm and xr. So that is 1.2 plus 50 square. So we can get the value of the Tp. So what should be, now we can substitute this all value into your calculator. So we are getting the value of Tp. So what should be the value of the Tp? We are getting directly value of the positive sequence torque, and that would be the 125.45 newton meter. So this will be the value of your positive sequence torque of your problem. Okay. Similarly, we can get the value of the negative sequence torque. So for negative sequence torque, what will be the change? We want to replace this slip with minus s, that will be the only the difference. So we can get the value for the negative sequence, the direction is changed, so minus 1 divided by omega ms, the value of your T into I square into xm square into r dash r upon 2 minus s, because it will be the negative sequence, the slip value is changed. Again, below that r dash r upon 2 minus s bracket square plus xr and xm, we can substitute this all value of xr and xm, that is x dash r plus xm bracket square bracket complete. Now we can substitute all these value into that equation. Again, we are getting that will be the 3 into 24.25. Okay, into xm, xm value is 50, the value square, that is xm square, that will be the 50 square into r dash r, that is 0.4 divided by 2 minus s, that is 2 minus 0.05, I can directly write it as 1.95. Okay, I can directly write this term as 1.95, because 2 minus 0.05 is 1.95 divided by, I can substitute value, that is 104.72 bracket, that is value of the R dash R, that is 0.4 divided by 0.05 whole term bracket square, plus XR and XM I can write, that is 51 point. Directly I can write, this will be the term as the 51 point basically 2 bracket square, because we are adding this 1.2 plus 50, we are getting directly term. Okay, this is 1.2, 1.2 plus 50, 2.2 plus 250, that will give you 51.2 whole bracket square. So, friends, this will give you the value of your negative sequence torque. So, we are getting the value of the negative sequence torque. So, what should be the value of the negative sequence torque? Simply, we can write, we can substitute this all value into your scientific calculator. We are getting the value of the negative sequence current. So, the name itself indicates it is a negative direction. So, the value of the torque is 3.29 Newton meter. So, this will be the positive sequence torque. This will be the negative sequence torque. So, if you want to get the net torque on your motor, so if you want to get the value of the net torque of your motor, this is called as net torque of your motor. So, if you want to get the net torque of your motor, obviously TP, actually TP and TN, that will be the product. So, the value of the TN is negative, TP minus TN. So, now we can substitute the value of the TP, that is 125.45 minus 3.29. So, we are getting the value of the net torque. So, what should be the value of the net torque? It is 122.2 Newton meter. But friends, what we want to calculate? We want to calculate the value of the speed, because earlier we have find out the value of the current, that is 24.25, but now we want to find out the value of your speed. So friends, and now we want to calculate the value of the slip at that particular case. So at normal case, the slip of the value of your slip is what, 0.05. so if you want to get the value of the rotor speed at that particular equation, so we are having the rotor speed equation, omega m is equal to omega ms into 1 minus s. So we are having the value of the omega ms into that particular equation. So we are having the value of the omega ms, that is radian per second, 104.72 into 1 minus s. So we are getting the value of omega m, means the rotor speed at that particular problem, in terms of radian per second. So we are getting the value of the omega m in terms of radian per second, that will be the value 99.5 radian per second. Okay, so this will be the value of the omega m. But friends, in the given problem, we want to find out the value of your speed at the rated RPM. So we are having a fundamental formula, that is omega m is equal to 2 pi n by 60. So friends, simply we can substitute the value of the omega m into that equation. So we want to calculate the value of what? N. So it will give you N is equal to omega m by 60, omega m by 60 into 2 pi. So now we are substituting the value of the omega m, that is 99.5 divided by 60 into 2 pi. We are getting the value of speed, that is N, is equal to this term. It is 950 RPM. We are getting the value of the speed directly, that the value of the speed is what? 950 RPM, and that will be the required solution of your problem. So that will be the required solution of your problem, because we want to find out the value of the current that we had already derived. Now we want to calculate the value of the speed at that particular operation. So we are getting the value of the speed at that particular operation, that is 950 RPM. So this will be the required solution of your problem. It will be the required solution of your problem. So friends, in that particular equation, again we have the value of basically your load torque. So friends, load torque, as we know that the for the steady state operation, we are having the motor torque is equal to load torque. So friends, in the given problem, as we seen that the motor current is less than the full load current. So in the given problem, we are having value of the full load current. This is the value of the full load current that we had already calculated earlier. So the value of the current is near about 30 ampere. So the value of the current, it will be 30.5 ampere. And when the single phasing will occur, the value of the current is what? 24.25 ampere. So this value of current is what? Lesser. So friends, if the value of the current will be the lesser, then obviously the motor current is less than the full load current. That's why the motor will be run safely. If the value of the current is greater than that the rated current, then motor will not be safe. But if the value of the current, it will be less than your rated current, that time the motor will be safely run on that particular single phasing fault. So friends, this will be the required solution of your problem. Thank you.